another video. As y'all see, we got Ron White, the reason we buy women diamonds, you know what I'm saying? Definitely geeked up to get in this reaction. Know a lot of people was commenting Dr. Phil, but Dr. Phil, make sure I drop that tomorrow. I know a lot of people want to react to Dr. Phil as well as the reason we bought women diamonds. But Dr. Phil was definitely something that was heavily requested. So gonna react to that tomorrow. So make sure y'all stay tuned. Definitely mess around white though. Definitely funny as hell. So we gotta get in this reaction. Make sure you hit that like button, subscribe button. Let's get in the video.
Here he is, juggling very bad habits with very good comedy. It's Ron White.
And I do apologize, this transparent. I be getting blocked, especially on a lot of these stand-ups. Some of my things.
Thank you. I'm 44 years old and I'm in the best shape of my life. I work out. Yesterday I was sitting in a beanbag chair naked eating Cheetos and I was flipping through the television and I saw Robert Tilton. He's a televangelist from Dallas and he was staring at me.
It do be them times when commercials come on and they know exactly what to say. Like exactly.
So it's great to be here. I almost died on Wednesday getting here. I didn't almost die. I didn't even get hurt. I flew here from Ottawa because my agent doesn't own a globe. I flew here on a plane this big, like a pack of gum with 8 people in it. Was scary. What happened was we took off from the Ottawa Airport Hair Care and Tire Center there. We're traveling at half the speed of smell. We get halfway to Montreal, we gotta go back. It's a 9-minute flight. We can't pull off with this equipment. We did. We had engine trouble. We lost some oil pressure in one of the engines, and they told us about it over the speaker system of the plane, which was stupid because they could have just went, "Hey, we lost some oil pressure." Heard ya. Sure did. It was weird. Everybody on the plane was nervous, but I'd been drinking since lunch, and I was like, take it down. I don't care. You ever have one of those days? You don't care if the plane stays in the air or not? Yeah. The guy sitting next to me is losing his mind. Apparently, he had a lot to live for.
You're wrong.
He did. He goes, hey, man, if one of these engines fails, how far will the other one take us? Like, all the way to the scene of the crash.
Exactly.
Yeah, which is pretty handy because that's where we're headed. I bet we beat the paramedics there by a half hour. We're hauling ass, that's what we're doing. I drink too much. Other people learn things when I drink. Last night a limo driver learned if I say I got a yak, it doesn't mean I have a long-haired buffalo living in my backyard. They asked me if I wanted to go to a topless club last night, and I didn't want to go, and then I ended up going anyway, because you guys backed me up on this. You've seen one woman naked. You want to see the rest up naked? It could be an old biker chick, you know, they're going to hang down here. You want to see me naked? Yeah, I do.
This dude, man.
Reading a magazine today, somebody is, De Beers, the diamond people are getting very close to truth in advertising. They're not there yet. I bet they're there by next year. The old slogan was diamonds are forever. Then they switched it to this year, take her breath away. The new slogan is Diamonds Render Her Speechless. Why don't they just go ahead and say it? Diamonds, that'll shut her up.
Is that really what they want to say?
I was in Miami when Hurricane George hit the Keys. And I thought this was funny. Everybody was evacuated the Keys from the Keys except for one guy who's going to stay there and tie himself to a tree on the beach to prove a point. And the point was, he said, that at 53 years of age, he was in good enough physical condition to withstand the wind and the rain from a Force 3 hurricane. Let me explain something to you. It isn't that the wind is blowing, it's what the wind is blowing. If you get hit with a Volvo, doesn't really matter how many sit-ups you did that morning.
Exactly.
I'm from Texas. In Texas, we have the death penalty, and we use it. If you come to Texas and kill somebody, we will kill you back. There, how's that? They're trying to pass a bill right now through the Texas legislature that'll speed up the process of execution in heinous crimes where there's more than three credible eyewitnesses. If more than three people saw you do what you did, you don't sit on death row for 15 years, Jack. You go straight to the front of the line. Other states are trying to abolish the death penalty. My state's putting in an express lane.
Right.
Thanks for playing along. That was fun.
Damn. Now, y'all got to keep on commenting more Ron White. I can react to Ron White really every day. Him and George Carlin and Dave Chappelle. All day, every day. You know what I'm saying? But y'all already know, keep commenting down below. Definitely appreciate everybody tuning in and watching. Much love to everybody. Hit that like button, that subscribe button. Catch you on the next one.